your worship.
We have to reach the Empress before Corypheus. The only question is, how?
We know how. I have our way in. The real question is, where is our enemy hiding? At the urging of Grand Duchess Florian, the Empress is holding a ball. Absolutely everyone will be there. During the festivities, Celine will be meeting for peace talks with the usurper Duke Gaspard and Ambassador Briala.
The assassin must be hiding within one of these factions.
What do we know about Duke Gaspard?
The man who would have been Emperor. He's Celine's cousin, and was first in line to inherit the throne when Emperor Florian died. Celine outmaneuvered him. She won over the Council of Heralds, who hold authority over title disputes. She became Empress, and he a general in the Imperial Army. He's well-loved by the troops. He's also a Chevalier. Most of their number sided with him when he turned on the Empress.
Aren't the Chevaliers part of the army? Why would they follow the Duke?
Most Chevaliers are sworn to serve the crown, but that does not give them faith in the person wearing it. The Empress has tried to improve relations with Ferelden and Navarra. The Chevaliers see her as anti-military. They believe Gaspard could lead the Empire back to the glory of Draken's expansion years.
Who is this Ambassador Briala?
An ambassador in name only. She has organized the elves of Halam Sheral into an underground army. The Empress invited her to the peace talks in a bid to gain the elves' alliance in the war. That would be scandal enough, without the rumor that Briala is a jilted lover of Celine's. A personal grudge and a network of saboteurs at her command. Promising lead.
Wait, the elven leader is a jilted lover of the Empress.
It's not widely known. Just a rumor whispered among the palace servants a few years ago. If it's true and where to get out. The Empress and an elf. The scandal could destroy Celine's court. Even if a lie, Briala could use it to blackmail the Empress. She has some connection to the throne.
Tell me everything we know about the Empress.
Empress Celine is a renowned diplomat and reformer. She works tirelessly to secure peace for the Empire. Unfortunately, many Orlesians view peace as complacency. She has yet to name an heir, leaving the future of the Empire in doubt if anything happens to her. Especially when the next in line is her cousin Gaspard, who's made few friends on the Council of Heralds.
Celine is surrounded at all times by countless guards, courtiers, servants, and vassals. What better place for an assassin to hide than the Empress's own household?
How can Gaspard still be next in line while he wages war against his Empress?
The title Grand Duke indicates that he was a prince before the Empress took the throne.
You've given me plenty to think about.
With Gaspard and Celine's armies entrenched, we cannot openly march troops to the palace.
My agents will ensure your soldiers get inside. But it must be a few at a time to avoid attention.
Understood. Just give the word, and we'll begin.
The political situation in Halam Shiral hangs by a thread. The Empress fears our presence could sever it. The Grand Duke is only too happy to have us at the ball as his guests, so our invitation comes from him. Whether we act as his allies or upset the balance of power, he gains an opportunity, if not a clear advantage.
Inquisitor Trevelyan, we meet at last. I've heard so much about you. The rumors coming out of the Western Approach say you battled an army of demons. Imagine what the Inquisition could accomplish with the full support of the rightful Emperor of Orlais.
And which one was the rightful one again? I keep getting them confused.
The handsome, charming one, of course, my lady. I am not a man who forgets his friends, Inquisitor. You help me, I'll help you. My lady, are you prepared to shock the court by walking into the Grand Ball with a hateful usurper? They will be telling stories of this into the next age.
I can't imagine that crowd has seen anything better than us in their entire lives.
You're a woman after my own heart, my lady. As a friend, perhaps there is a matter you could undertake this evening. This elven woman, Briala, I suspect that she intends to disrupt the negotiations. My people have found these ambassadors all over the fortifications. Sabotage seems the least of their crimes.
That sounds like something I should look into.
Be as discreet as possible. I detest the game, but if we do not play it well, our enemies will make us look like villains. We're keeping the court waiting, Inquisitor. Shall we?
Is that the Inquisitor?
What? A martyr? Don't be absurd!
One of the Trevelyans, I've heard.
Pardon me, my lady. Have you seen a ring anywhere? It was a gift from the Comtesse Montbelliard, enchanted by the Fomari. I cannot go into the ball without it.
That's a terrible predicament.
If the Comtesse finds out, make her have mercy. Should you happen upon it, I beg you, let me know. What am I going to do if I cannot find my ring?
Is this the ring you are looking for?
You are a treasure! I cannot believe you found it! You have saved me a lifetime of mortification. How can I thank you enough?
This is a private conversation. Please, leave. Any word from the front lines?
My spies said the bodies were beyond counting.
Surely the Empress will put an end to the war tonight.
Pray, my friend. If the Maker does not hear us now, just pray.
Is here.
Maker, I hope not. It's been too long since I've had any word from Valois.
The Inquisitor.
A martyr? The Maker has an honor.
Thank you.
Inquisitor, a moment, if you please. I'm sure you know how to handle most nobility, but the game is nothing like the Free March's intrigues. It is no simple matter of etiquette and protocol. Every word, every gesture is measured and evaluated for weakness.
I'll keep my guard up. Don't worry.
The game is like wicked grace played to the death. You must never reveal your cards. When you meet the Empress, the eyes of the entire court will be upon you. You are safer in the Fade with the Fear Demon.
It might be a good idea for the others to hear this warning. Especially Sarah. Maybe tell her twice.
I'll have a few discreet words. Everything will be fine. And Raste watch over us all.
How can they call this a vestibule? It's a foyer.
Please, it's barely half the size of the foyer in the...
I heard the Grand Duke invited the Inquisition.
I had hoped to tour the Royal Wing Gardens again.
I have heard they are the finest.
Boring.
What is Gaspar up to? It wouldn't surprise me.
Take some time to get our men into the palace. I'll alert you when we're ready.
The sooner we go in, the sooner we can get this over with.
And now presenting Grand Duke Gaspard de Chalon, and accompanying him, Lady Inquisitor Trevelyan, daughter of Ban Trevelyan of Ostwick. Vanquisher of the rebel mages of Ferelden, crusher of the vile apostates of the mage underground.
So full of it. That's not how it went.
Champion of the Blessed Andraste herself.
Did you see their faces? Priceless.
Accompanying the Inquisitor, Seeker, Cassandra, Allegra, Portia, Calogera, Philomena.
Get on with it.
Pantagast, 14th cousin to the King of Navarra, 9 times removed. Hero of Orlais, right hand of the divine. Lord Dorian Pavus, member of the Circle of Arantium, son of Lord Magister Hallward Pavus of Azariel. Her ladyship, my bulls each, of course. Sir Callum Stanton Rutherford of Honleith, commander of the forces of the Inquisition, former Knight Commander of Kirkwall. Lady Liliana, Nightingale of the Imperial Court, veteran of the Fifth Blight, Seneschal of the Inquisition, and left hand of the Divine. And Lady Josephine Charette Montillier of Antiva City, ambassador of the Inquisition.
Cousin, my dear sister.
Grand Duke, we are always honored when your presence graces our court.
Don't waste my time with pleasantries, Celine. We have business to conclude.
We will meet for the negotiations after we have seen to our other guests.
Inquisitor?
Lady Inquisitor, we welcome you to the Winter Palace. Allow us to present our cousin, the Grand Duchess of Leeds, without whom this gathering would never have been possible.
What an unexpected pleasure. I was not aware the Inquisition would be part of our festivities. We will certainly speak later, Inquisitor.
Your arrival at court is like a cool wind on a summer's day.
I am delighted to be here, Your Majesty.
We have heard much of your exploits, Inquisitor. They have made grand tales for long evenings. How do you find Halamshiral?
I've never seen anything to equal the Winter Palace.
We hope you will find time to take in some of its beauties. Feel free to enjoy the pleasures of the ballroom, Inquisitor. We look forward to watching you dance.
Inquisitor, a word when you have a moment.
Tell me, lad, how are my men? Are they in good health? Do they want for anything?
Josephine! Oh, Josephine! Is this her?
Inquisitor, please allow me to present to you my younger sister, Yvette Gabriella Montillier.
There can never be too many Lady Montilliers in Thedas, can there?
Inquisitor, I've heard so much about you, but not as much as I want. Josephine writes, but she never tells me anything. Is it true? Rebel mages in Redcliffe were performing blood rites and orgies before you stopped them.
Where did you hear such nonsense?
Everyone in Antiva says so. Is it true?
Those stories are little more than wistful thinking, my lady.
Oh, how dull Redcliffe must have been, then.
Which power should the Inquisition throw its weight behind?
Celine has held the throne successfully for years. I see no profit in ousting her. Gaspard has run military campaigns, but never a kingdom. His transition would be, let us say, chaotic.
Tell me about yourself, Lady Yvette. This is the first time I've encountered any of Josephine's family.
She would forget to mention the artists. I've been studying painting under Antiva's royal tutors. You should be proud, Josie. I'm going to be exhibiting my work next season in the city's biggest salon.
Have you actually sat down and finished the painting yet?
I must wait for my inspiration.
And I must wait for your tutor's bills.
Enjoying the ball?
I see many of them. The dancing is so dull, your worship, but the Empress's gallery is magnificent.
Yvette.
Sorry, Joseph.
Go on, Josephine.
Half our royal must be empty. So many of the Empire's finest are in attendance. They've noticed the Empress paying you special attention, but they don't quite know how to take advantage of it yet. This uncertainty won't last long, I'm afraid.
This may be my only chance to hear about when Josephine was a girl.
Oh, yes. As she told you about when she was 10 and...
Yvette. Stop.
Fine. What about when we were climbing the cliffs by the...
No.
She once told the Duke of...
Absolutely not.
Hmm. She still plays with her doll collection when no one's looking.
Yvette! That's absurd. Absolutely preposterous.
I'll see you later.
Another time.
I heard Celine was having the entire wing redecorated. But the timing is atrocious.
As a bastard.
Why would she do such a thing now?
What a fun, close marrying crowd.
Making any new friends?
Not likely. I'm watching them watch you. They're all glances and titters. Not sure if they're allowed to like you yet. Pathetic.
Think I can get you to dance with me later?
Me on their precious tiles? That's a good one. Besides, I don't. That's not me, yeah? Couldn't be me.
Any thoughts on who we're investigating?
The Empress is pretty. It'd be fun to drink and kill stuff with Gaspard. Briala is friggin' funny. Elves. But it's really a pissing match with an old lover. Don't know the rest, but that explains a lot. They're all lying, but Celine's nice to look at. Good thing we're here to save her neck.
Any hidden treasures from friends of your little network?
You mean, do any of the servants ferrying tarts between these windy tits hate them enough to give up a stash or two? I'm not saying yes, but... Wait, yes I am. There's some good stuff hidden around. Keep an eye out.
Back soon.
Not going anywhere.
We can speak later, Inquisitor.
Smile,
how could the
Commander?
Empress afford
you're
to
so
renovate
handsome
the palace
you smile?
Without war going
He's
on?
He's just as handsome.
I heard that it wasn't renovations at all. The
Inquisitor,
damaged
did you need
Gaspard's
something?
Catapult.
The sooner we track down this infiltrator,
the
better.
Palace? That's monstrous.
We'll talk later.
I await your signal.
What were they doing in the Western Approach? It's a wasteland.
Lady Nightingale makes me nervous.
I am because in her thought.
Good. I was hoping it would catch you. What did the Duke say? He points the finger at Ambassador Briala. The Ambassador is up to something, but she can't be our focus. The best place to strike at Celine is from her side.
Empress Celine is fascinated by mysticism. Foreseeing the future, speaking with the dead, that sort of rubbish. She has an occult advisor. An apostate who charmed the Empress and key members of the court as if by magic. I've had dealings with her in the past. She is ruthless and capable of anything.
How can Celine openly keep an apostate in the Imperial Court?
The Imperial Court has always had an official position for a mage. Before now, it was little better than court jester. Vivian was the first to turn that appointment into a source of real political power. When the circles rebelled, technically every mage became an apostate. The word lost much of its strength.
That sounds exactly like the person we're looking for.
She's worth investigating. Can't be sure of anything here. Both leads point toward the guest wing. It's a promising place to start. I'll coordinate with our spies to see if I can find anything better. I will be in the ballroom if you need me.
This ball is a waste of time, like all Orlesian foolishness. Let's find the Venatori collaborator and get out of here.
Stay alert. We don't know where the enemy is hiding.
I'll be watching for trouble. The sooner we leave this place, the better.
Just gossip. Good to know.
We are not serving drinks. Order someone else. The package is in the guest wing. Upper room.
The one of the garden. Statuette.
Interesting. Good to know.
Gaspar is wasting.
Boring. I should look around.
Well, well, the Inquisitor. Here as a guest of my nephew, no less. I'm curious.
I didn't know the Grand Duke was your nephew.
He's my brother's eldest boy. Always a difficult child, Gaspar. Never listened, never did what he was told. He was raised a prince. All his life we told him he would be emperor. It was his destiny, his duty. What else should he do with his life if not fight for his destiny?
Another time, my lord. Waste of time.
Get.
You don't want to be here, stranger.
He hasn't made the pickup. It's been hours.
He went into the servants' wing. Nobody's come out of there all night.
I'll tell Briella we have a situation.
Did you hear what Gaspard said to Duke Germain? His own uncle.
Germain bore his nephew's spite better than the rest of the council. Did you see that panicked in the Shiro?
Well, well. What's this?
This way is closed. Please, use the main entrance to the pool room.
My lady! My lady Inquisitor!
May we have a word? It is very important.
The Empress has sent us with a message for you.
I'm always honored to hear from Her Majesty.
Oh, she is the honored one, Inquisitor.
Empress Celine is eager to assist the Herald of Andraste in her holy endeavor.
She will pledge her full support to the Inquisition as soon as the usurper Gaspard is defeated.
That's a generous offer.
The Empress believes wholeheartedly that the Inquisition is our best hope for peace in these difficult times.
She looks forward to cementing a formal alliance.
As soon as Gaspard is out of the way.
But we have taken enough of your time.
Please, enjoy the masquerade, Inquisitor.
Interesting. Just gossip.
Did you need something?
Interesting.
You must be mistaken.
No, I'm quite certain it was blood on the tiles.
If they're playing the game, they're not doing it very well. You don't leave evidence if you play to win.
With Gaspard and that elf woman here, the only one playing to win is Celine.
You only say that because you fancy the Empress's pet apostate. It sickens me to think of the chaos those Maleficarum are causing across the Empire.
Even you cannot deny that the Templars abandon the faithful in their darkest hour. How can you condone that? They are the ones who should be brought to heel, if you ask me.
The only one to survive the Temple of Sacred Ashes, yes.
This is all so familiar. I half expect my mother to materialize from the crowd and criticize my manners.
Is this how the elite of Devinter carry on?
You could almost mistake this for a soiree in the Imperium. The same double-dealing, elegant poison canapes. It's lacking only a few sacrificial slaves and some blood magic. But the knight is still young.
Have you seen anything I should know about?
So far, this seems like harmless political intrigue. A few murders arranged, some scandals contrived from nothing. Like a homecoming, honestly.
What if your mother were actually here? Where'd we be then?
Short one mage after he's dragged out by his earlobe.
I'm having difficulty picturing that.
Picture me a young boy of 5 years, then. She certainly always has.
I appreciate that you were willing to come here.
And expose myself to all this exquisite finery and exotic wines? Such hardship.
Not everyone's likely to be friendly. That's all I meant.
It's true. You'd think I smelled of cabbages the way they wrinkle their noses. It's of no concern, but thank you.
Gaspar is wasting his time. Nothing he does could win over the castle.
The war will end tonight.
Just gossip.
Philippe should have returned hours ago, dallying with some serving girl while I deal with Gaspar's vitriol.
Awfully selfish of this filly, running off to play and leaving you with all the work.
I've half a mind to inform the Dowager. That would teach him to shirk his duties to roll some elven maid. Tonight of all nights, leaving me to convey Gaspar's death threats to the Council. Wonderful timing, Philippe. Thank you for listening to me, Rand. You are too kind, Inquisitor.
The last two people we sent to the servants' quarters have failed to report.
Leave us.
Well, that's useful.
Wasting his time.
I heard the Inquisition was here.
Gaspar is wasting his time. Nothing he does could win a race against me.
Inquisitor, are you enjoying the ball? This is your first presentation at court, is it not?
I am Lady Marcellette, court historian to Her Imperial Majesty.
What exactly does a court historian do?
I am responsible for the historical records of the court. I maintain our library and record all official proceedings.
Are you here to chronicle the events of the evening for posterity?
Oh, yes! This is a momentous occasion. The first meeting between the Grand Duke and Her Majesty since the war began. Even if, Maker forbid, the talks should fail, it is an important moment in the history of the Empire.
Good evening, Lady Marcellette.
Another time, perhaps.
Get these pastries out.
I am done talking.
The Duchess has asked for two men. I can't carry them all.
Germaine bore his nephew's spite better than the rest of the council. Did you see that panicked attaché roaming about?
That's the bell. I should get back to the ballroom.
Where has that servant gone? Elves.
Gaspar is wasting his time. Nothing he does could win a race against me.
That would be the second bell. Fashionably late now.
Well, well. What have we here? The leader of the new Inquisition. Fabled herald of the faith. Delivered from the grasp of the Fade by the hand of blessed Andraste herself. What could bring such an exalted creature here to the Imperial Court, I wonder? Do even you know?
We may never know. Courtly intrigues and all that.
Such intrigues obscure much, but not all. I am Morrigan. Some call me advisor to Empress Selene on matters of the Arcane. You have been very busy this evening, hunting in every dark corner of the palace. Perhaps you and I hunt the same prey.
I hope so. I could use another ally here.
A sentiment I share, considering recent events.
Recent events?
Recently I found and killed an unwelcome guest within these very halls. An agent of Tevinter. So I offer you this, Inquisitor. A key found on the Tevinter's body. Where it leads, I cannot say. Yet, if Celine is in danger, I cannot leave her side long enough to search. You can.
You left Celine alone. Is that wise?
I must return to her anon, but she is safe enough, for the moment. 'Twould be a great fool who strikes at her in public in front of all her court and the Imperial Guard.
What's your interest in protecting Empress Celine? Are you her bodyguard?
Do I seem a bodyguard to you? If anything were to happen to Celine, eyes would turn first to her occult advisor, even if they knew otherwise. There are sharks in the water, and I will not fall prey to them. Not now, not ever.
Why did you kill the agent? He might have had useful information.
I would not have slain the man on sight had he not attacked me first. Why? Undoubtedly, I caught him in an illicit act. I did not know from whence he came until after the battle, and regret only that I could not capture him alive. What intentions the Imperium has here, I suspect you know far better than I.
If you truly want answers, help me find them.
I already told you. I must return to protect the Empress. Proceed with caution, Inquisitor. Enemies abound, and not all of them aligned with Tevinter. What comes next will be most exciting.